Very good morning, friends. I hope you're all safe and healthy. So we were having a discussion on a series on hedge accounting, and I have done three videos so far, where in the first video I gave you introduction to hedge accounting. Then we covered the step number one as well as the step number two in the second and the third video, where we were talking in terms of the hedged item as well as the hedging instrument. Now today we're going to talk in terms of the step number three. The step number three is, you can say from an examination point of view, quite theoretical in nature, where we need to basically see that there is a qualifying criteria for hedge accounting. That means if a company wants to apply hedge accounting, there has to be certain parameters which needs to be met. Let's see in detail the step number three. An academy पर आ रहा है सुपर ओवर बैच एफ आर और एस एफ एम का एक कॉम्बो नवंबर 21 अटेम्प्ट के लिए, और इसके अंदर बैचेस शुरू हो रहे हैं 19 मई से. और इसके लिए जो बैच है वो एक बेसिकली एक प्रैक्टिस बैच होगा. सर, प्रैक्टिस बैच का मतलब ये कि आपकी एक कंसेप्ट की एक रिवीजन होगी और साथ में क्वेश्चंस इसके अंदर प्रैक्टिस किए जाएंगे. और इस बैच के अंदर मैं फाइनेंशियल रिपोर्टिंग ले रहा हूँ और SFM ले रहे हैं सुशांत अरोड़ा सर. और इसके लिए आपको सब्सक्रिप्शन के अलग अलग प्लान्स अवेलेबल हैं. अगर आप सिर्फ ग्रुप वन के प्लान्स लेते हैं तो 3 ईयर्स यानी 36 मंथ से लेके 3 मंथ्स के अलग अलग प्लान्स हैं, जिनमें मुझे लगता है सूटेबल प्लान 6 मंथ्स का बैठता है. और 6 मंथ्स के प्लान पे आपकी सब्सक्रिप्शन बैठती है, जिसके अंदर पर मंथ बेसिस पे निकालें तो तकरीबन 2000, जिस पर आप 10% डिस्काउंट भी अवेल कर सकते हैं और मेरा कोड इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं CAKB10. ऐसे ही ग्रुप टू के भी अलग अलग सब्सक्रिप्शन प्लान्स अवेलेबल हैं. हालांकि रेट्स उनके बिल्कुल कॉमन हैं, लेकिन इधर 6 मंथ्स के अंदर अगर आप कॉम्बो ऑफर में लेते हैं तो आपको थोड़े और डिस्काउंट्स मिलते हैं. 6 मंथ्स में 3750, जिस पर फर्दर 10% डिस्काउंट मिलता है मेरा कोड इस्तेमाल करने पे CAKB10. तो आइए लेट्स क्रैक इट. नाउ इन स्टेप नंबर थ्री, व्हेन वी से दैट देयर इज अ हेजिंग रिलेशनशिप व्हिच शुड मीट अ क्वालिफाइंग क्राइटेरिया, इंडस 109 इज वेरी क्लियर एंड इट सेज दैट यू नीड टू मीट ऑल द फॉलोइंग कंडीशंस. नाउ देयर आर अ टोटल ऑफ थ्री सेट ऑफ कंडीशंस व्हिच वी नीड टू मीट. Let's look at each of these conditions one by one. The condition number A is that the hedging relationship consists of number one, eligible hedging instruments and eligible hedged item. Now, if you remember, this is what we covered in the step number one and two. You know, in step number one, we identified that there are certain hedged items which need to be eligible. And in step number two, we've already seen which hedging instruments are supposed to be eligible. So when you look at that, you want to establish a qualifying hedging relationship, we need to ensure that step number one and step number two have identified the hedging instruments and the hedged items which are eligible. The next condition is that at the inception of the hedging relationship, the management needs a formal designation as well as a documentation of the hedging relationship. Now, if you remember, when I gave you the introduction to hedge accounting, I very clearly made a mention that, you know, hedge accounting overrules the general accounting principles which are laid down in the Ind AS. Like, for example, as I said, a debt instrument which is measured at a fair value through OCI, you would take the fair value changes to other comprehensive income. But due to hedge accounting, the fair value changes are going to be taken to the profit and loss account. So it is very important that even as an auditor, if let's say I go for doing an audit of a company, I should be very clear that such kind of instruments have been, you know, designated as hedging instruments. So we would be very clear with the picture that management has got some kind of written documentation. So when you say that there is a formal documentation, so there would be a written documentation of the hedging relationship. So management needs to do a documentation that they've decided to carry out hedging relationship. So what kind of hedged items and what kind of hedging instruments have they identified for this purpose? And in this particular documentation, they also need to lay down very clearly what is the entity's risk management objective. So what is the objective and what is the strategy they are going to undertake in order to, cover up this risk factor. So this is the second condition in terms of qualifying hedging relationship. Now, when you say that there has to be a formal designation and documentation, now what are the various components in terms of this documentation that is also been laid down in Ind AS 109? So there are almost like, four parameters which are given as a part of the documentation. So identification of the hedging instrument, identification of the hedged item, which is basically step number 2 and 1, I would say, in the given order. The nature of risk which the management wants to hedge, and how the entity will assess whether Ind AS 109, which deals with financial instrument, would meet the hedge effective requirements. So the documentation that the management is going to do should identify these four parameters. So the two conditions what we have done, now let's have a look at the condition number 3, which is the final condition in order to meet a qualifying hedging relationship. The standard says that the hedging relationship meets all the following hedge effectiveness requirements. Now, what is a hedge effectiveness requirement? Let's read and then I'll elaborate. It says there is an economic relationship between the hedged item and the hedging instrument. Now, when I say there is an economic relationship between the two, indirectly we are saying that the fair value changes of the hedged item and the fair value changes of the hedging instrument should flow in the opposite direction. Because only if they flow in an opposite direction, then only, we can get some offsetting advantages when you're going to take the fair value changes of both the instruments, that is the hedged instrument and the hedging instrument, in the profit and loss account. So the management needs to basically ensure that there is going to be an opposite changes in fair value arising on account of the hedged item and the hedging instrument. Secondly, we need to identify a hedge ratio. The hedge ratio of the relationship is that it results from the quantity of the hedged item and the quantity of the hedging instrument. Basically, you can say that there has to be a little mathematical parity. Let's say, for example, if the entity wants to hedge, let's say, 1,000 debentures invested in a company, then it would also need to consider a derivative contract which is going to comprise of the same lot of shares, that is 1,000. So there may not be a mismatch in terms of the quantity of the hedged item and the quantity of the hedging instrument. Otherwise, the level of effectiveness of the hedge is not going to be appropriate. And unless the hedge ratio is going to be effective, we cannot carry out a hedging things. Now, you would say, what is an appropriate hedge ratio? Well, there is nothing which is defined, but generally we would see that a 90-95% hedge ratio is going to be an effective call. So these are the total three parameters which are laid down in Ind AS 109, which tells me that once you've identified the hedged item, step one, second, the hedging instrument, now it's time to identify that the hedging relationship between the hedged item and the hedging instrument is qualified, is supposed to be a qualifying relationship. So this is all on the step number 3. We're going to see you in the next video in terms of the step number 4. Thank you and take care.